us that we were about organizing this meeting, you know, it really pushed me.
Yeah.
Because I think we're so pressurized and there were a lot of things that needed our attention.
Yeah.
And I almost said no. But I'd really love his push and his persistence. I think a lot of questions have been answered. Because I really was worried. You know, when we talk about the lifting up of sanctions, you know, really, when we look at Zimbabwe, we always consider that these sanctions are really for one man. You know, this has always been our way of seeing things.
Yeah.
It has always been about one man, and some of us felt, no, I think let him continue to feel the pinch a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I think that has been our way of looking at this issue.
Yes.
But I think when you began to talk, and you especially when you talked about Bethlehem, and you spoke about this lady in Gaza, and you know, I felt it, no, there's something happening.
Mm-hmm.
Something is breaking out there. And you could feel that this is not just an issue about just doing it for pleasing other people, but this is breaking a barrier.
Amen.
I think I've been answered, because I've looked at Zimbabwe, I've looked at the political scenario, I've looked at how, you know, this antagonism between the political parties, and how other people, you know, felt, now we are the people. You know, when you were coming in, I was just reading the paper, it was still Mkoko back. And I'm seeing these people come and say, lifting up of sanctions. And yet Justina Mkoko is getting in. And I was saying, no, I think I have a question to ask. You know, can we lift up sanctions whilst Justina? But I think it goes beyond Justina Mkoko. I love my country.
Yes.
That's one thing I'm committed to Zimbabwe. I'm passionate about Zimbabwe. I really love my country. Yeah, this is the truth. And when you begin to speak, I begin to realize, you know, the love of my country must go beyond my way of thinking. You know, she spoke about barriers. The racial barriers, the tribalism barriers. And I remember very well the conference in Masvingo. There was a lot of tension.
Yes, there was.
There was a lot of tension. And I remember one man standing up and saying, you know how these dissidents went around. He didn't know. Like, Americans don't know what's happening in Zimbabwe.
When I was speaking there.
Yes. This man did not happen in Matabele.
Yes, right.
And only what he was seeing on papers. And I began to understand, no, I think as Christians, we need to go beyond politics.
Yes.
We really need to. I really appreciate this, and I appreciate his persistence.
Mm.
And I think we're enlightened. It really has been an eye-opener.
Mm.
And I think we will stay there.
Well, Pastor James, I want to say to you that it's been that in August of 2006, okay, and we meet here again today, that you understand that our commitment is not just a passing thing, okay, and that we are here, and we really have in our hearts the commitment of Rahab, okay? It's our life for yours.
Hallelujah.
And God has given us that kind of love. And you know what? There's just no mistaking love.
Amen.
There's no mistaking love.